Many of you will be aware of the movie The Life of Pi, an emotional, action-packed journey filled with twists and turns. A story of difficult situations demanding difficult decisions. But what many may not be aware of is where the original inspiration for the name Richard Parker came from, and the terrifically spooky coincidence attached to its history. Richard Parker originally appeared in the works of Edgar Allan Poe, a writer of epic proportions. Born in 1809, he is most famous for his series of short poetic stories, now classified as macabre. At the time, these stories would have been straight-up horror. Although Edgar had various strings to his bow, he is also widely regarded as a central figure of Romanticism in the United States. He was one of the country's earliest practitioners of the short story. Poe is also generally regarded as the inventor of the detective fiction genre, and is further credited with contributing to the emergence of the genre of science fiction. In 1838, Poe's novel, The Narrative of Arthur Gordon Pym of Nantucket, was published. Partway through the book, the crew of a ship named Grampus find themselves adrift with no food or water. They manage to catch a tortoise, but eventually, in order to survive, the crew draws straws to decide who would perish to provide food for everyone else. The short straw would go to a mutineer named Richard Parker. Poe describes the event in all its horrifying glory. Poor Parker promptly stabbed to death, his head, hands, and feet eventually thrown overboard. Parker's reluctant offering keeps the floating party alive just long enough to finally be rescued. A creative story which Poe actually considered very silly. However, this story would eventually have a plot twist in reality, which I'm sure even Poe would have been impressed by. It would occur in 1884, some 35 years after Poe's death. A boat named Mignonette would leave England bound for Sydney, Australia. Unfortunately, the boat was not suited for the journey and sunk in a storm due to the voyage. Four crew members would escape the vessel in a life raft, one of whom was named Richard Parker. A 17-year-old deckhand, Parker would fall overboard a few days into their ordeal, foolishly drinking seawater in an attempt to quench his excruciating thirst. After pulling him back on board, Parker inevitably quickly began to deteriorate due to the added impact of the salt intake on his already drying body. In another event, startlingly similar to Poe's story, the men consider drawing straws to see who should give up their life. But due to Richard Parker's quickly deteriorating condition, they decided that he should be their unfortunate victim. Ultimately, the three men would survive, thanks to Richard Parker's foolish decision. What's more, amazingly, not one but two real events consisting of the murder of sailors named Richard Parker have actually occurred throughout history. Was this Richard Parker the original inspiration of Poe? It's likely, yet unknown. Richard Parker, 16th of April 1767 to 30th of June 1797, was an English sailor who was executed for his role as President of the Floating Republic, a naval mutiny in the Royal Navy at the Nore between 12th of May and 16th of June 1797. It's amazing to think that the name Richard Parker should show up in three separate occasions involving grisly deaths at sea. Is it a strange coincidence, or did Poe sense something unexplained regarding the name Richard Parker? It's safe to say, if your name is Richard Parker, you should stay away from sailing.